If you ever find yourself in southern Colorado, nestled along the eastern side of the Rocky Mountains, near the Sangre de Cristo range, you will find two prominent peaks known as the Spanish Peaks. Rather interesting geologically, from an aerial photograph you can see that these two central core peaks have these linear features radiating out in all directions from them. Now, it's hard to tell from an aerial photograph what the nature of these linear features is, but down at ground level, we can see the two Spanish peaks, and these linear features appear as walls of rock sticking up out of the ground around them. Now, the peaks themselves are giant masses of magma that froze underground, what we call batholiths. This entire area was uplifted during the Rocky Mountain formation, and is now eroding down at a rather rapid rate geologically, and so we see these resistant, igneous bodies standing up against the background land. The dikes were igneous walls of magma that came up with these giant masses of magma and froze in place underground as well. As the land erodes down, they too stand out, like my stepdaughter who just won the spelling bee. They stand out from the background land around them because they are more resistant to weathering and erosion.
Yeah, we really are.
If you go down into the valleys, you can see that these are not exactly insubstantial walls. They actually stand up rather tall. Here, this particular dike is weathering away in a stair-step manner, and we can see from this perspective that it's actually radiating directly out from the central eastern peak. Now, as we pass by, we can see how thin and tabular these features are, and that they often come in sets, and not just alone. As they weather away, they are more resistant than the rock around them, but they do tend to break down through chemical weathering at their edges mostly. And so we see the outer edges of this particular dike crumbling away, whereas the central core looks a lot more resistant and pristine. Now we refer to these as dikes, and not sills, because they cut across the grain of the rock that's around them, what we call the country rock. If it was parallel to the country rock, we would call it a sill, but this dike may have eventually made it up to the surface to feed what we call a fissure eruption at the surface. On the other side of that peak, there's actually a dike that crosses the road so that a tunnel was built through it. The cracks in the rock are known as joints, not faults, because no movement has occurred along them. In other places around this area, you will see these dikes, and you can see, as in this case, that they've burned the rock, the country rock that they intruded into. So this central core of this linear feature is actually an igneous dike from magma. However, on either side we see a baked zone in the Sangre de Cristo formation. Here at the dike that crosses the road, the rock on either side has also been baked while still in the solid state, making it a friable, that is a rock that breaks apart rather easily, a friable metamorphic rock that we call hornfels. This is also where I saw something rather interesting and a little disturbing.
Oh, he's eating his face off. Oh yeah, he's eating his head. Do you want to see a baby bat getting his head eaten by a beetle?
No.
Why it does?
No, I can't believe that. I thought for sure.
I'll be darned.
Yeah, tell me about it.
Isn't that amazing?
Look out, Cecily, look out.
I think he's going for the eyes.
Oh my God.
Yeah, that's probably the best part.
One of the issues that photographic geologists come across is that you need to have something for scale. It's hard to tell exactly how big this beetle is next to this bat, but when you finally understand that this is
a widow baby bat. We need a finger for scale.
We clearly need something for scale. This is also where I saw a series of trees that were bending, and if you ever see trees like that, it indicates that the slope is moving downhill and is unstable. This is also where I saw a deer relieving itself in the most interesting way in somebody's front yard. And so that's what you might see if you come to the Spanish Peaks. So that's our brief tour of the Spanish Peaks and their associated radiating dikes. If you ever happen to be on the eastern side of the Rocky Mountains in southern Colorado, here in the United States, on this beautiful planet we like to call Earth.